Hi, fans. Welcome to another exciting action-packed hour of Smoky Mountain Wrestling. Professional wrestling the way it used to be and the way you like it. I'm Bob Caudle, and we got a great show in store for all you fans this week. And by the time you see this program, Thanksgiving Thunder Weekend will be well underway. It'll be in full swing. Now, today, we're going to see Tim Horner, Dixie Dynamite, and the Heavenly Bodies. We got a video spotlight, which is going to feature the Rock and Roll Express and our dream match, and it's for the heavyweight title. Ronnie Garvin will take on the Dirty White Boy, my tag partner right here, Dutch. Dutch, everybody, take that thing off. Everybody knows that's you.
Well, I just want to do a little different twist here. Everybody pay attention. Today, my special guest on Down and Dirty with Dutch will be none other than Nitro Danny Davis, and I'm going to ask him point blank why he hasn't learned to keep his neck out of Paul Orndorff's business.
All right, we're about ready with action, fans. Right now, let's go to the ring.
Wrestling fans, introducing from Chattanooga, Tennessee, 222 pounds, here is Paul Lee.
Thunder rolls and lightning strikes. Another love goes.
All right, Paul Lee, and right now, making his way into the ring. Hey, this guy, Sunshine, I don't care what you say about him. A tremendous athlete, a great competitor, liked by fans everywhere he goes. Number one, White Lightning, Tim Horner.
From Morristown, Tennessee, 232 pounds, White Lightning, Tim Horner.
Now, what do you say? I can say what I want to about him. All I'm going to say about him is he's a backfighter. He attacks people from the backside, jumps on them when they're unaware. But why would I say anything bad about
it? I don't know. You must be, you got to be talking about somebody else. I don't think I know that person that you're talking about. Good move right there by Horner with a wrist. Brings Lee right down to the mat. You know, today in Knoxville, you know what that means.
Today,
Thanksgiving Thunder.
Thanksgiving Thunder rolls into the Knoxville Coliseum at 3 o'clock. And going to be a lot of wild action. That's only a few hours from now.
And Horner is really geared for the Dirty White Boy and the title in that lumberjack match, too. You know, he's going to have four of his friends outside of the ring, and four of the Dirty White Boy's friends are going to surround the ring. Eight guys, if somebody gets out in that lumberjack, they're going to throw them back in.
Let me tell you, I just hope I'm one of the lumberjacks, because what I'm going to do when Tim Horner comes flying my way, which I know is going to happen, I'm going to pick him up by that stringy blonde hair.
Are you going to be one of the ones outside?
I might be if I want to be. I'll almost snatch him bald-headed, throw him back in the ring. But it's hard to get a man back in the ring when he's crying and begging and pleading with you to leave him alone. But
never
hey,
happened.
He got himself into it. He made his bed. He's going to have to sleep in it.
Never happened. Never happened.
Today in Knoxville.
All right, here's Paul Lee now as he backs Horner back to the corner. Gets a shoulder right in the midsection. Comes with that big chop right back across the chest of Horner. Horner using the ropes in the corner goes right outside on the apron of the ring.
Up on
with the
top.
Right hand now from the top rope. There's that flying press. And him only for the count of two. For all you fans who are watching Catch 43 in Knoxville, as Dutch mentioned earlier, the Thunder Tour rolls into the Coliseum at 3 o'clock today.
3 o'clock. Tim Horner going to be there. Rock and roll. I'm going to be there. Let me say one thing. Tim Horner's in there against a young man that I expect might have some future stars. Paul Lee has shown me a lot in the matches he's had here on Smoky Mountain Wrestling. And what an upset it would be. Tim Horner going into Thanksgiving Thunder goes in with an upset with Paul Lee beating him right here today.
Oh, that'd be a tremendous upset. I ain't any doubt about that. And it'd be what a feather in the cap it would be if Paul Lee.
Oh, yeah.
Here you see Horner showing you he's got a lot of power. Not only has he got Dutch, I'm going to upset you with this. Not only has he got a lot of quickness and speed and agility in that ring.
Oh,
yeah,
goodness.
He has power, too, as you saw him scoop up Lee and slam him hard to the mat.
Well, another suplex by Horner.
Oh, man, look at the speed with which he did that one, Dutch.
Well, he ought to do it good. I've done it to him about 1,000 times. I taught him the move.
Beautiful move on the part of Tim Horner. Now when Lee comes off, Lee goes right behind Horner, but he blocks that right hand, and Lee ducks under that roundhouse right.
Wait a minute, going in behind him is a reversal.
Is he going to go with the bridge? Yes, sir, Lee. The small package in the bridge.
Your winner of the match, White Lightning, Tim Horner.
Well, a good win for Horner right here on the eve. Just a few hours away, Thanksgiving Thunder rolls in the Knoxville like Bob Collins said, a reversal by Horner. Goes behind Paul Lee. Now, Tim Horner does this move very well, but then again, he ought to because I've taught it to him about 100 times, but he gets the win right here on Paul Lee, right here on Smoky Mountain Wrestling. There you see Tim Horner with his hands in the air. Let's go right now. Standing by, Bob Caudle with a dirty white ball and the legendary Ron Wright.
All right, and Dutch, you're right, and here he is, Mr. Ron Wright and the dirty white boy. White boy, our heavyweight champion right at the moment, but he's got a lumberjack match facing him. The tide could turn. The whole thing could turn around just like nothing.
Bob, you shouldn't be talking like that. I've been worrying for a week over this match, and I tell you, it's coming up right here to Knoxville today, and they've stooped so low. I've been going around trying to get our four men lined up in our corner, and I'm finding out that Tim Horner and some of his cohorts been paying them off, and I'm not being able to get the men that I really want, but I assure you one thing, we'll have four men down there. Somebody will be down there to help my beloved man hang on to this title one way or another right here this afternoon.
Outside of the ring, they're going to throw you back in.
What happened to the guys that you had signed up for this, Ron?
Some of them trying to back out, but I've still got people in the corner. Don't worry about it too much.
Okay.
Old Ron will come up with something. We'll get this thing worked out before.
Because this man right here is a man of his word. And we're on a mission, Tim Horner. And that mission is to get this legend out of this chair. Now you got all your buddies going to line up around the ring. I got my buddies. I'll see you in K-Town, Horner.
All right, fans. We'll be back right after this. Fans, before we talk to Commissioner Bob Armstrong, let's take a look at an interview sent in by Primetime Brian Lee, who is still recovering from injuries sustained at the hands of Kevin Sullivan.
Kevin Sullivan, good news for me. Bad news for you. As you can see, my stitches are out, my bruises are healing, my burns even healing. But I'm still not 100%, and the doctor hasn't released me. All that does is give me time. The doctor tells me if I come back in the ring too soon that the injuries you gave me broke my ribs, bruised my liver, my spleen, that it could be fatal. And I don't want to have any excuses this time, because when I get my hands on you, and we stand face to face, it's not going to be a pretty sight. And all I have is time. And every day that goes by, I count down to when I can put my hands around your little throat.
All right, fans, you just heard that from Primetime Brian Lee. And here is Smoky Mountain Commissioner Bob Armstrong. Commissioner?
Well, I'll tell you, Thanksgiving thunder is upon us. And I'll tell you, Kevin Sullivan, when you hear that thunder roar, brother, it's going to roar in your ear for years. We got the Monster Stomper coming back just for you, Kevin Sullivan. You ain't going to get away with what you did to Primetime Brian Lee. He's coming back to do the job, and he is the man that can do the job. He's the baddest man in all the land, better than Leroy Brown or anybody else. So thunder is here, brother. Thanksgiving thunder is here. Bring your followers. Come on, brother. Because me, I'm going to enjoy watching a Stomper take you apart and just a little taste of what you're going to get right away. Here's a little film on what the Stomper does to folks just like you, Master.
And the bout is underway. Without the introductions, the Stomper, an unofficial meeting with Dennis Condrey, and right away he catches him in the midsection and starts that vicious stomping. Bearcat Wright from the side of the ring with a PA mag, Mike, following the instructions. Ooh. Andre pounded again. The big fella at 271 pounds. An easy 35 to 40 pound weight advantage over Dennis Condrey. This could be it for him. One, two, three, and that is it. That had to take less than a minute of action. They had it marked down as 142. May have been a little long because he really wasn't there long.
And the following is a paid commercial announcement. Smoky Mountain Wrestling is not responsible for and does not necessarily agree with or condone the viewpoints expressed by Kevin Sullivan.
You know, now the people, besides my foes, the people that watch Smoky Mountain Wrestling, realize I'm for real. You see, they've sent all of them after us, and we're still here. Commissioner Armstrong. You sent the Mongolian stomper, a man that you once hated. Now you shake hands with them. You have shaken hands with the enemy. And the enemy is you, Commissioner Armstrong. You see, I'm not going away. I was strapped to the tree of woe. Eagles plucked at my breast. Nothing could stop the march. And Brian Lee, I hear a rumor. I hear a rumor, Brian Lee, that you're getting out of your sick bed and gonna crawl down and maybe somehow give an inspiration to the stomper. Brian Lee, let me tell you a story. You see, there are books about near-death experiences. You can go to any library and get them out. If you don't have the money, call us. We'll send you a donation. You see, in near-death experiences, you always see the light. You always see the light. And that light says, take care of yourself. Do not get any other near-death experiences, Brian Lee. And Stomper, that goes for you, too.
And Smoky Mountain Wrestling is coming to Pippa Passes, Kentucky on Friday, November the 11th at 8 p.m. You'll see Tim Horner against the Dirty White Boy, Mr. Wonderful Paul Orndorff against Ronnie Garvin, Kevin Sullivan taking on the Mongolian Stomper, and a tag team title match, the Rock and Roll Express taking on the Heavenly Bodies. Be sure to watch Your Mountain Television, WYMT, for more details. And Smoky Mountain Wrestling is returning to Barberville, Kentucky at the Knox Central High School on Friday, December the 4th at 8 p.m. You'll see a Smoky Mountain title match, the Dirty White Boy against Tracy Smothers. Kevin Sullivan taking on the Mongolian Stomper, and a six-man grudge match, the Rock and Roll Express and White Lightning Tim Horner against the Heavenly Bodies and Jim Cornette.
You see what they're doing? You see, I brought this food stamp out. I picked it up last time I was up there in Eastern Kentucky. I brought this food stamp out last week. I showed you people what they look like, but of course you already well know. Now I find out because of what happened last time in Barberville. Last time Smoky Mountain Wrestling was there. Now Bob Armstrong has forced a six-man tag match on me where I'm going to be in the ring. Well, let me tell you something, Rock and Roll Express, and you, Tim Horner, you stuck your nose in, Horner, where it didn't belong last time, and now you're going to pay the price for it. Because we ain't playing around no more. We ain't talking about food stamps. We ain't talking about those welfare cases. We ain't talking about the fact that you people in Eastern Kentucky don't have the guts and the courage to come up and publicly thank me living in Jefferson County, all my life paying taxes where there's big businesses, big banks, big buildings, big people paying the money to support your stinking families all these years. You don't have the guts to come up and thank me. No, you demand a six-man tag match. Well, let me tell you this, Rock and Rollin' Horner. The Heavenly Bodies are going to stand in front of me, brother, and they're going to keep you from getting to me because I'm not a wrestler. I'm not an athlete. I realize if you get your hands on me, you'll break my neck. You'll break me like a biscuit. But that ain't going to happen. And all those people in Eastern Kentucky, all those welfare cases, they're not going to have the privilege of seeing it. No, they're not. They're going to see one thing and one thing only, the Heavenly Bodies' hand raised in victory.
All right, fans, and with me right now, this young fella right here that we are delighted to have with us in Smoky Mountain Wrestling. And I tell you, he's been cutting a wide path in Smoky Mountain Wrestling, still undefeated since coming to Smoky Mountain Wrestling. Here's the wild-eyed Southern boy himself, Tracy Smothers. Tracy?
Thanks, Bob. You know, Bob, I don't want to sound corny, but I want to thank Commissioner Bob Armstrong, yourself, and Sandy Scott for making me feel at home. Oh, it's such a pleasure to be back in the South. And it's such a pleasure to be amongst the people that I grew up around. You know, it took a long time for me to realize that the best things in life are free. And that, you know, you can take the boy out of the country, but you can't take the country out of the boy. I was born country, and that's what I will always be. You cannot take away the fact that I'm a Southern-born, Southern-bred thoroughbred, guaranteed not to rust, bust, collect dust, bin break, or splinter. Born on a mountain and raised in a cave. Women and wrestling is all I crave. And speaking of women, I'm going to tell you this. The short time I've been in the Smoky Mountain area, I've seen the prettiest Southern belles that the good Lord ever put on this earth.
Well, I tell you, not only are you going to cut a wide path in the ring, maybe outside too, Tracy, like that, huh?
You know, I was talking to my old buddy, Dixie Dynamite, and I understand he's got a match coming up next, and I know he's going to put that Confederate kick on somebody, on some poor soul. He's got them herds of dynamite. So, Bob, it's a pleasure to be here. I'm on that stairway to heaven, man. I'm going to climb that great Smoky Mountain itself, and I want a shot someday at that Smoky Mountain heavyweight title. Remember, I'm American by birth, and I'm Southern by the grace of God.
All right, continued success to you, the wild-eyed Southern boy, Tracy Smothers. Let's go to the ring, fans. All right, fans, Jeff Daniels in the ring. Got a bundle of energy right now making its way to the ring. Mask it on, and the fans, especially all the youngsters, really adoring. Tremendous
well, let me ask
success
you something.
For him in Smoky Mountain Wrestling, DC Dynamite.
He's got a mask on. Why don't you ask him to take his mask off? You asked me to take mine.
Well, we don't know who he is, but everybody knew who you were, Dutch. I mean, all that hair and all that beard and everything sticking out from under that had to be you.
From the heart of the Confederacy, 260 pounds, here is DC Dynamite.
A great announcement by our ring announcer here, Brian Matthews, the voice of FM 94 in Marion, Virginia. I just thought I'd throw that in there.
Well, Dixie Dynamite right away has made a mistake when he turned his back in the corner on Jeff Daniels. And Daniels very quickly charging across the ring, attacking Dixie Dynamite from behind with those power blows right to the back. And now that big, powerful left hand was high on the far, and he's going to introduce him to the turnbuckle over in the corner.
You know, Jeff Daniels first made an appearance here, debuted at Smoky Mountain Wrestling a couple weeks ago. But, you know, he's a fairly decent wrestler in his own right. And then again, you know, see Smoky Mountain Wrestling, he could be very easily, Dixie Dynamite goes in as a favorite in this match, but, hey, he could be upset just like anybody else.
Any doubt about that.
Except me, of course. I don't get upset.
Well, you can just scoop up Dynamite, slam him hard, and slam him to the mat. Dutch, you know, hey, I really enjoyed talking and listening to Tracy Smothers. You know, he's quickly becoming the most popular athlete in Smoky Mountain Wrestling. And I tell you, he's just an all-around fine young man.
Are you through now?
I'm through now.
Yeah, he's got a record that's fairly impressive, but he hasn't really been tested. I may have to test him myself. Or the Dirty White Boy might have to test him. Or Paul Orndorff might have to test him. Or what? Jimmy Cornette and the Heavenly Bodies, they may have to test him.
Look at Dynamite. He went from corner to corner with a turnbuckle.
That was right on the button
kick.
There.
Hook that leg. 1, 2, 3. There you have it.
Your winner of the match, Dixie Dynamite.
All right, we got a visitor in the ring.
From behind.
There's
look
one.
At this, the big Night Stalker. Look how huge this guy is. 6'8", about 317 pounds.
Watch this. Boom.
Oh, my heavens.
What a power bomb. Did you see that?
And then Dynamite. What the heck? He's taking on both of them. What's he trying to do in there, Dutch?
Here come some guys, obviously, to help out. Now, what's wrong with these guys? Big kick by Night Stalker. There goes Robbie Eagle.
Something's got to be wrong with you when you go looking for a man like this, the size and the power and the strength of the big Night Stalker.
Well, there is something wrong with them. They're hurt now. They were just insane before.
Reno Riggins now coming in from behind.
Now, Tracy Smothers is in the ring. No, Reno Riggins is in the ring. It's hard to see who's actually. There's so
that's
many
right.
laying out
Dixie
on the
Dynamite
floor.
Still down on
wait a minute, now here comes, Tracy Smothers and Tim Horner. Wait a minute. Ooh, two of them. A big double team, Bob.
They got a double team on the Night Stalker as they whip him back across the ring. Double clothesline him over the top rope and out of the ring he goes.
But it took two of them. Hello, everybody. Welcome to Down and Dirty with Dutch. I'm Dutch Mantell, and you're not. Like I said at the top of the program, my special guest today on Down and Dirty with Dutch is Nitro Danny Davidson. Danny, I'm going to have to ask you some hard questions. What I would like to know is how long it takes you to understand to keep your nose or your neck out of Paul Orndorff's business. Now, how did all this start? How did you get involved in it?
Well, first of all, I did not ask to be in a neck brace. You understand? Paula gave me a pile driver and almost ended my career. But let me tell you something. I didn't stick my nose into nobody's business. I was watching Rugged Ronnie Garvin's back like I always do because he's been a longtime friend, okay?
Okay, let me ask you this. How long are you going to sell that neck? How long is that neck going to be hurt? You've been walking around for a month or so with it on.
Well, let me tell you something. just a couple of weeks ago, I was able to get the feeling back into my right arm and my fingers. So only my doctor knows, and only Nitro Danny Davis knows just how long I have to wear this. And I'm not disclosing anything else, but I will say this. When the time is right, I can assure you that Paula Orndorff will know.
Okay, let me. Thanksgiving Thunder rolls into Knoxville today at 3 o'clock. Will you be there?
Yes, when Thanksgiving Thunder rolls around today, I will be there.
So you're saying you will be in Knoxville today. Ladies and gentlemen, we're joined in the ring here by Paul Orndorff. Paul, you have some comments?
Yeah, I do. Who does this little Pete Squeak think he is? You know who you're talking to? Mr. Wonderful. A man that is famous all over the world, and they got some, your head looks like it's coming through a toilet. You get it?
You did this to me. You did this to me. I guess you're real proud of yourself. You're a big, tough guy, right? Okay, you put me in this and almost ended my career. Do you have any conscience? Do you have any feeling? No, you don't.
Let me tell you something. You can't take Lassie and have Ren 10-10 to do the job. You're in a man's business, and if you don't, and if you can't handle it, then you need to go and wash pots and pans or stay home with the kids and let your wife go to work. You're in a man's business, kid, so be able to face it. That's what it's all about. Dutch, I'm sick and tired. Every time I turn around, you got this little peep squeak out here running me down. Who does he think he is, man? I don't even know.
Wait a minute, I ain't got nothing about this. Bob, I'm leaving. I'm history.
And Dutch takes off out of the ring. Nitro Danny Davis came off with that neck brace, jumped up under the back of Paul Orndorff. He's just riding him like the pony, got that neck brace now around the throat of Orndorff, and he's tightening it up. He may be choking Orndorff. Orndorff back into the corner to try to break him out free to get away from that. Now he's got Davis down in the corner, Dutch, kicking and stomping. You lost control of that whole thing, Dutch.
Control. Davis is smart. He's a smart man.
Look at Orndorff.
Davis has got exactly what he deserves coming to him right now.
Orndorff now with that foot on that throat and on that neck, and that neck now on that turnbuckle. That neck had already been injured from that pile driver, and Orndorff going right back to it again.
Well, I had to get out of there. I'm not involved in this, but Danny Davis should have left. He's got a hurt neck, or so he claims he has a hurt neck. He should have left. Only because of his stupidity is he in the position he's in right now.
Nitro Danny Davis down near the center of the ring as Orndorff just stands up down, taunts the crowd, and Davis holding that neck of his. And again, Orndorff with another elbow smash and a blow right to the neck and to the side of the neck. And Davis is saying now, you know, not on the neck again, Paul.
Paul Orndorff is begging.
Wait a minute, Dutch, not again. He's got him in a position where he's going to try to power drive him again. He's got him up, and he may try to foul right here. Comes running out. Curling in to save Davis in the nick of time. With a big right hand, down goes Orndorff.
Another backfighter.
All right, Dutch, it's your segment, but we'll be back, fans, in a moment. Say, Dutch, before we see the Heavenly Bodies in action, let's take a look at what happened in last week's six-man tag match. All right, and look at this team as they come bursting into the ring area. Rock and roll, Ricky Moore. Hey, and Cornette right away, something
wait
in the
what
eyes
do you do?
Of Morton. Morton's flailing around, something right in the eyes. All right, we got all four wrestlers in the ring right now. Referee trying to get two of them out, trying to get a little order restored.
Robert Gibson on the top.
Gibson's got Lane. Here's Cornette into the ring. It's three against two in the ring right now.
Cornette's
from behind.
In.
Cornette with a blow right to the back of Robert Gibson, and Gibson right down to the mat.
He smoked him. He hammered Robert Gibson in the corner.
He hammered him good, too, Dutch. And the referee now said, ring the bell. And Gibson was just about to get the stretch on Stan Lane, and again, there's the tennis racket of Cornette. Trying to go over the referee to get it after Ronnie Garvin.
Ricky Morton,
and here's Morton now with one eye with a patch on it, goes right for Cornette.
Cornette out of the ring. Stan Lane back in. Ricky Morton on the floor after Cornette. Tracy Cornette right in front of the announcer's table here.
Fans, it's wild in the ring.
Fans introducing at a total weight of 464 pounds, Robbie Eagle and Reno Riggins.
All right, tag team action right here, fans. Reno Riggins and Robbie Eagle already in the ring. And, of course, with that music entering the ring area right now, our Smoky Mountain Tag Team champions, along with their manager, Mr. Jim Cornette. And I tell you, these stars come out any time of day, and they do really shine the heavenly body. What does he mean, the conquerors
well,
of the rock and roll?
Well, he meant they conquered the rock and roll like the rock and roll were subservient to the heavenly bodies, which, in fact, is what they ought to be.
Dutch, before we get into this match, very quickly, I want to say, you know, it's really almost criminal what Kevin Sullivan has done to Brian Lee, but thanks to Bob Armstrong, Sullivan will have to deal with a Mongolian stomper who's one of the most dangerous men ever in the sport of wrestling. And that will happen this afternoon in Knoxville. And also, as of right now, you know, Sullivan and all of his followers are banned from television. It's Reno Riggins. Boy, he rolled up Tom Richard very quickly, couldn't hold him. With the arm drag, the hip toss, he went right to the hip toss of Stan Lane. That hurt. Boy, he's in trouble now.
You know,
this
Reno Riggins,
he goes after Reno Riggins,
he's a fairly decent wrestler, too. That's one thing I'll say about Smoky Mountain Wrestling. Every match you see on Smoky Mountain Wrestling is a competitive match, and they have been some upsets right here on television. Now, I don't like a lot of what Bob Armstrong's philosophy, but obviously he does not, he goes to great lengths and pains to put excellent matches on television for the fans. I will give him credit for that.
Yep. I think you're right.
He even begged me the other week. He said, Dutch, will you please wrestle on TV? I am not wrestling on TV for these stinking fans for free. I'm not going
to
do it.
All right, Riggins now having that leg pounded away by Pritchard, and Pritchard got him up in the air again. And there was that leg drop right down across that knee, and he's going to make the tag. Here's Lane. You know, the most dangerous match of the four faces of fear awaits the rock and roll in the heavenly bodies.
This afternoon.
This afternoon in Knoxville, inside a cage, Dutch, made of four-pronged barbed wire. And you know, that would slash you to ribbons if you try to get out of it or if you get thrown into it. That's an extremely dangerous match coming up this afternoon.
Well, anytime you have barbed wire around a match, of course it's dangerous, because when you have sharp objects pointing inward in you on all four sides, it's a very probably the most dangerous man in match in wrestling. I would say he'd be more dangerous with the rock and roll, because I just feel it in my heart that they're going to be trying to leave when the heavenly bodies really start laying on them. Tom Pritchard missing two elbows there. Robbie Eagle in with a drop kick on Pritchard.
Well, it was
another on Stan Lane.
Riggins made that tag, and Eagle coming with a good move. He was double-teamed right there. Lane from behind, Pritchard with that forearm blow, caught him and sent him flying.
Now, fans, if you tuned in late, our main event today, a match between the Dirty White Boy and Ronnie Garvin right here on TV, coming up shortly. So stay tuned. Don't go away.
It's going to be for the title, and that's our dream match. They got them both pinned. 1, 2, 3.
Fans, your winner of the match, the Heavenly Bodies.
Well, the Heavenly Bodies working their way toward Thanksgiving Thunder this afternoon in Knoxville at 3 o'clock in a confrontation with the Rock and Roll Express in a barbed wire cage match. And let's see the big move right here. We see Robbie Eagle going in and the backdrop with the power slam addition to it. And Robbie Eagle is down for the count. And right here, another move on Reno Riggins. Both guys down. It looks like roadkill, ladies and gentlemen. It looks like carnage laying in the ring. Now, let's go to the set right now, and let's talk to Bob Cottle. And he has Jim Cornette and the Heavenly Bodies standing by.
Right here. Also, Killer Kyle is joining.
Yeah,
this
yeah.
afternoon, I got to ask you about that. The most dangerous of all the four faces of fear, barbed wire around the ring in Knoxville.
Well, you see, by the time that you people out there watching this on TV see this thing take place, it's going to be this afternoon in Knoxville, Tennessee, at the Coliseum, a barbed wire match. You see my man Killer Kyle? I'm sure you'll see him there too, because after those maniacs have been trying to assassinate me, I'm not going to go nowhere without him. But I'll tell you something right now, and all of you genetic mutants, all of you idiots living downstream from the nuclear plant, you hear what I say. Last week you saw what happened to the Rock and Roll Express. I'm such a man, I nearly broke them both in half by myself and slapped Ronnie Garvin around for good measure. And today, in Knoxville, when you get in that barbed wire, Tom, I want you to remember, all you got to do is grab that pretty hair by the pretty back of the pretty neck and rub that pretty face in that wire a couple times, and they're going to look like your mother's coleslaw, with, maybe without the Malzetti salad dressing. What do you think?
I think so. Rock and Roll Express, you can count the hours and you can count the minutes, because this afternoon in Knoxville, Tennessee, I can promise you there will be blood, and it will be yours on barbed wire today. Ricky Martin, Robert Gibson, you're going to think you died and went to Vegematic heaven. We're going to slice you. We're going to dice you. We're going to peel all that pretty skin off your face in that barbed wire match. Just show up. I can't wait.
I can't even. Four-pronged barbed wire razor shop. You talk about a popeil pocket fisherman. You talk about one of those Vegematics. Well, brother, when we get finished with the Rock and Roll Express, they're going to be in so many pieces, they'll look like a jigsaw puzzle, but a couple of the pieces will be gone.
All right, they're talking about the Rock and Roll Express fans. I tell you, let's show you a little bit of the highlights of some of the matches with Rock and Roll right here.
The boys are back in town.
Hey, Dutch, go ahead. Tell us about the
dream match. Okay, our dream match this week. Fans, this week's dream match winner is Michael Melton of Seymour, Tennessee. Michael wanted to see the Dirty White Boy and Ronnie Garvin battle for the heavyweight title. Michael wins a package of Smoky Mountain souvenirs worth over $50. Now, let's go to the ring.
Fans, right, this is a dream match. It is for the Smoky Mountain heavyweight title. Introducing the challenger from Atlanta, Georgia, 235 pounds, the man with the hands of stone, Ronnie Garvin. And now introducing the manager, first Mr. Ron Wright. Now introducing the Smoky Mountain heavyweight champion from Bucksnort, Tennessee, 248 pounds, the Dirty White Boy. This is for the Smoky Mountain heavyweight title.
Well, I started to say Dutch earlier, before the ring announcer, he just butted in on me right there.
Of course
he
did.
But anyway.
He's from Virginia.
The Dirty White Boy,
you know,
our dream match.
You know the difference between Virginia and yogurt?
Virginia and yogurt?
Yeah,
no,
yogurt still has an active culture.
Oh, Dutch. The Virginia fans are not going to like you for that.
Why?
They're not going to like you, Dutch. Making fun of Virginia. All right, the
Virginia
bell.
Virginia is for love. This is what should be a very competitive match right here.
Oh, well, you got Ronnie Garvin. Hey, you know, you're looking at the Smoky Mountain heavyweight champion in there and the Dirty White Boy. Ronnie Garvin has been world heavyweight champion, held a number of championship belts. As you say, it's got to be a competitive match, Dutch, from the opening bell, I think, to the finish.
Well, what we're going to see here, we're going to see some strategy applied on both sides. Now, sometimes you see guys all, just tear from the get-go. They rip and tear into each other. But these men both have been wrestling for quite some time, and they know there's not a lot of weaknesses on both sides. White Boy is a very smart wrestler, even though his forte in the profession is brawling.
Well, and this is the first time that these two guys have met in the ring one-on-one like they are right now. And joining me out here at ringside, here is White Lightning, Tim Horner. And Tim, we got a whale of a match going up there in that ring, but also we got some whale of a matches coming up, a number of them this afternoon in Knoxville.
That's right. You know, it's Thunder, the Thunder Tour, you know, Thanksgiving Thunder.
That's right.
And it's going to be some thunder for that Dirty White Boy in Knoxville this afternoon, you know. I'm going for that Smoky Mountain heavyweight title. It's been on my mind for a long time. And I know Ronnie Garvin, you know, when we get to Knoxville this afternoon, Dirty White Boy may not have that title.
You know, the guy has done everything in the world, Tim. I think to waylay you, to move you aside or whatever. He's hit. Well, we saw him hang you once from the ropes. He had your hands handcuffed behind you when he drug you to the ring, just hung you from the top rope. Then we saw him take a beer bottle and conk you right across the forehead. It's a wonder you got any brains left after that, really. The guy has tried any and everything he could, Tim, to put you out and to put you permanently out.
Well, that's right. You know, the Dirty White Boy, he's got to be thinking, I'm pretty tough or I'm stupid one or crazy, you know, and maybe I'm a little of both, Bob, at this point. You know, if Ronnie Garvin was to win the Smoky Mountain heavyweight title, you know, it wouldn't change anything between me and the Dirty White Boy, because I still want the Dirty White Boy in the ring.
Oh, I agree. And I know that's the feeling, Tim. It's not you'd love to have and you want that championship belt around your waist, but it's the fact that you've got a lot of debt to repay. That guy's put some scars on you, and it's payback time.
Well, that's right. You know, when I come out here, I just wanted a chance. And Ronnie Garvin, he just wants the chance, and he deserves a chance as much as anybody.
Garvin with that big blow right there. Boy, the White Boy felt that one.
That'll get your attention quick.
Oh, that got his attention. He's calling for timeout, and there's no timeout as he's down in the corner. And that was not even a closed fist. That just shows you what kind of power Ronnie Garvin has got behind that right hand of his.
He's got a lot of power. You know, Ronnie trains hard. I used to go up and down the road with Ronnie. We were in the gym every day. He trains hard. He's one of the toughest men I've ever met, you know. And I try to train with him and, you know, try to stand toe-to-toe with Ronnie in the gym, you know. But, you know, he's a tough man, and that White Boy is feeling that right now.
Well, we're talking about Thanksgiving Thunder. We're talking about this afternoon too, Tim, in Knoxville. You know, we got a lineup of great matches, and not only you and the Dirty White Boy, where you're gonna be after some skin and some scalp off of the White Boy. We talked earlier about what about Cornette and his guys? in a cage match against the Rock and Roll. I say cage, I'm talking about barbed wire around that thing, four-pronged barbed wire. And that's, I guess, the most dangerous match anybody could come up with.
It is dangerous. You know, I'm not an animal, and I don't like cages too much, especially with barbed wire around them.
Sure.
It's going to be a tough match. I'm gonna get me a good seat for that one.
And right now, Ronnie Garvin is reeling around in that ring, and a big, hard right hand right there from the Dirty White Boy. And here's Garvin quickly back to the attack with those right hands of his own.
Well, the White Boy found him an opening, but it closed up quick. It's like a football player going through the line, and all of a sudden he's got a hole, and then he doesn't. He thought he had an opening on Garvin, but Garvin closed it back up on him quick.
And Garvin into the corner right after him. Tim, I got to ask you this. I see Mr. Ron Wright outside of the ring there in that wheelchair. In several of the matches that you've been involved in and where you've been around the White Boy, interviews or whatever, when the White Boy's had an opportunity to attack you, it seems to me that Ron Wright has always had a hand in that some way.
Well, he likes, you know, when the Dirty White Boy gets in trouble, you know, he knows Ron Wright's out there, you know. And Ron is a distraction sometimes, you know. I know he's not going anywhere in that wheelchair, but still, he's an important factor in the Dirty White Boys matches.
Well, the White Boy now with Garvin on the mat comes with a big knee. You got any special plans or anything special that you're going to be doing with Ron Wright outside of the ring today?
Well, in these Lumberjacks coming up in these Thanksgiving Thunder tours,
yeah.
Ron Wright won't be a factor because there's going to be eight guys around that ring. And if the Dirty White Boy wants to go out, there's going to be eight guys throwing him back in.
Yeah, that's some match, too, when you talk about that. There's no way a guy can go. He's got nowhere to run. He's got to stay in the ring and fight. If he gets out, he's going to come right back in.
That's right. You know, the White Boy, he should have thought about swimming before he jumped in the water over his head. Like I said, and you said earlier, you know, he's hit me with beer bottles. He's hung me upside down, you know, and I bit my tongue almost off there. And, you know, he's running now. He don't want this match.
Well, Tim, I just want you to know that if you throw him toward me, I'll be more than willing to throw him back in there. I hate somebody to run away.
I'm sure you will, Dutch.
And we got both of them down out near the center of the ring.
What's Ron doing? Look at Ron.
Yeah, Ron Wright.
I'm going to stop this.
He looks like he's getting something out of his shirt here. Wait a minute. Here comes Tim Horner.
Wait a minute.
And Horner over there to try to break this up. He's got the White Boy by the hand and Ron Wright by the hand. It looked like the Wright was trying to give the Dirty White Boy something, and now Horner trying to take it away from Ron Wright.
A big punch by
there
Garvin.
There goes the White Boy from a big right hand by Ronnie Garvin.
Garvin's got him down.
And the referee looking at Tim Horner. Garvin's got him down, and there's no referee there to count. Here comes Paul Orndorff now.
Wait a minute. What happened here? One, two.
Oh, wait a minute. He stopped at a count of two.
What's going on here?
What the heck is happening right now? Orndorff, wait a minute. They're showing that chain. I think Orndorff must have thrown that in the ring. He did.
No,
Orndorff threw that in. He did. He threw that chain in.
I didn't see it.
Yeah, and the referee now thinks that Garvin had that around his fist. Orndorff is saying, yeah, that he did.
Oh, yes. I see. The referee is right.
And the
Garvin.
Referee now raises the hand of the Dirty White Boy.
Well,
wait a minute. Here comes our other referee. He's saying no. No way. He's waving that off.
Wait a minute. Who won that?
I don't know.
What's
going
on here?
We'll try to find out later. We'll be back in a moment.
Fans, Smoky Mountain Wrestling is coming live to Pippa Passes, Kentucky on Friday, December the 11th at 8 p.m. You'll see Tim Horner against the Dirty White Boy, Orndorff against Garvin, Kevin Sullivan against the Mongolian Stomper, and a tag title match, the Rock and Roll Express against the Heavenly Bodies in Pippa Passes. Be sure to be watching Your Mountain Television, Channel 57, for more details. Also, Smoky Mountain Wrestling is returning to Barberville, Kentucky at the Knox Central High School, Friday, December the 4th at 8 p.m. You'll see a Smoky Mountain title match, the Dirty White Boy against Tracy Smothers. Also, Kevin Sullivan against the Mongolian Stomper at a six-man grudge match in Barberville. The Rock and Roll Express and White Lightning Tim Horner against the Heavenly Bodies and Jim Cornette.
Well, you know, it's just like old times, Jimmy Cornette. It seems like that every time your team gets in trouble, that you got to stick your nose in there. Just like the last time we was here in Barberville, you see Jimmy Cornette, we had your Heavenly Bodies beat. But what'd you have to do? Stick your nose into our business. And I want to thank Tim Horner for coming down and helping us out. But you see, this time things are going to be even. Well, I could say they're kind of even, but Jimmy Cornette, you're on the Heavenly Body side. On our side, it's White Lightning and Tim Horner. And when White Lightning and Tim Horner and the Rock and Roll Express get together, All we do is create stormy weather. And let me tell you, Tim Horner, come on in here, baby. Here's the man right here in Barbersville. What are we going to do?
I'm going to tell you what we're going to do. You know, I'm all for a fight, Ricky. But it's, I like an even fight, tell you know. Brother. That's why I come down. Mm. And Cornette, let me tell you something. We're pretty tight. I'm going to tell you tight. If I want money, I know where to go. If I want a handshake, I know where to go. But let me tell you something. I'm going to tell you where to go. And when Barberville, you know what he's going to do? Oh. I'm going to tell you what I'm going to do. I'm going to do the Texas two-step on your head and a boot scooting boogie on your butt.
Oh, right.
And when we get that there, you go rock and roll, little country kicking. Uh-huh. That's what you're going to get, Cornette. So just come on down. We'll tell you what it's all about.
That's right, Jimmy Cornette. Come on down there this time, baby. Stick your nose in there because I can't wait to see you in a pair of wrestling tights.
Accommodations for this event were provided by the Fairfield Inn in Johnson City, Tennessee. Quality accommodations and world-famous Marriott hospitality at down-to-earth prices. For a 60-year Marriott tradition of warm, friendly service, visit the Fairfield Inn. To make your reservations, call area code 615-282-3335. All right, fans, and we're still trying to sort out what happened there in that last match. Commissioner Bob Armstrong here with us. What's the decision on that, Commissioner?
Well, I'm going to take it on myself right now. I'm going to declare Ronnie Garvin the winner of that match because of what happened. Now, I can't give him the title because a three count never occurred. Yeah. So he'll go down as the winner of that match. However, I can't take the title away from Dirty White. Boy, my hands are tied right there. It looks like Paul Orndorff just cheated him out of a chance at that title, a title that he had won as far as I'm concerned. And you know, Thanksgiving Thunder's rolling around, brother. Everybody's been talking about it. It's finally here, and the Thunder's going to roar, folks. And we're going to see that Kevin Sullivan. He's going to take one that somebody needs to be...
Hold up there, Mr. Well, Commissioner. Well, let me tell you something. I bet you figured, right, where's the stable tonight? Because they're not going to be here at all. I got a surprise for you. We are here. You know, I never had much respect for this man before, but I respect you very much as Commissioner here. I want to tell you, this is the finest tag team, and you know it well. And you know it well, little fella, that ever stepped in anybody's ring, Smoky Mountains or anybody else, and we have beaten the Rock and Roll Express, we have come on the television program, and we have beat your Fantastics. There's nobody here we haven't beat, except the Heavenly Body. We are the best. Do it. Any question about that,
sir? No question is, listen, I've had a bad day. Let me just say this. You want a championship match? What I'll do is, I'll give you a championship match with the Heavenly Bodies. And if you'll just come back next week, I'll tell you when and where, and you can have your title shot and kiss my grip.
All right, man. He says you can have it, the title match with the Heavenly Bodies.
You think that you scared the stud stable? You think that bothers us, Bob Armstrong? That don't bother us at all, because we are the best. We'll beat anybody to put in the ring with that.
I don't care about that, man. I don't care about that.